from Novato Gymnastics. Today I'm going to lead you through a quick complex that you can do at home anytime to work on your jumping and leaping for balance beam. If you don't have a floor beam at home, that's okay. You can do this just anywhere on the floor as long as you have enough space. You can also create a line on the floor using painter's tape or the edge of a carpet or the edge of a yoga mat. Get creative and make a straight line at home. All right. Let's get started. So we're going to start in beam feet. Hips are square. All 10 toes are on top of the beam. So your feet are pointing forward and not out to the side. Very good. Hands on hips. Let's focus on our posture. So from our knees all the way up to our head is one nice straight line. Buns are under, abs are in, shoulders are down, neck is long. Very good. Let's go ahead and hold releve for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Try to keep the weight on your big toes. 3, 2, 1. Lower down. 10 heel raises. Ready, lift. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hold for 10. We're going to bring our arms out to the side. 9. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands back onto your hips. We're going to go into a forced arch. So glue those knees together. Press the fronts of your feet forward. Plie. And stand tall. Very good. We're going to move into our 8 count. Ready? 1, which is a plie. 2, forced arch. 3, releve. 4, flat feet. 5, releve. 6, forced arch. 7, plie. 8 is stand. Very good. Let's try that again. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good. Now we're just going to plie and go up to releve and hold. Very good. Plie, up to releve and hold. You have to really squeeze your buns. Abs stay tight. Shoulders are down. Two more. Plie, releve and hold. Last one. Plie, releve and hold. Very good. Shake it out. Shake out those legs. We're going to do the same sequence now on the other side. So go ahead and turn around. Other foot should be in front. Focus first on our feet and our posture. So all 10 toes are on the beam or on your floor line. Abs are tight, bottom is tucked under. Shoulders are down, neck is long. Hands are on your hips. Hold releve for 10. Knees are glued together. Weight is on your big toes. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower down. Heel raises. Ready. Lifts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And hold for 10. Bring those arms out to the side. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands onto your hips. Go ahead and push to a forced arch. Knees together. Hold. Plie. Stand. Good. We're going to try the 8 count on this opposite side. We'll do the first one nice and slow. So the first position is a plie. 1, forced arch. 2, high releve. 3, 4, 5, forced arch. 6, plie. 7, 8 is just a nice tall stand. Good. Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good. Now plie. Hold releve. Squeeze the buns nice and tall. Good. Plie. Releve, hold. Good. Plie. Releve, hold. Last one. Plie. Releve, hold. Very good. Shake out your legs, stretch out your feet. You're really working on your ankle stability and your calf muscles and your leg muscles. So you should feel your feet getting a little tired. That's good. That means you're doing it correctly. All right. Okay, now we're gonna practice jumping. I like to teach jumping with our hands on our hips, so you're really forced to use your legs. Start in beam. Beam feet, so all 10 toes on the beam. Hips and toes are pointing forward. Good. Start in a plie. You're simply gonna jump up, keeping your back flat, push and point through those toes, and then land in the same plie position. So, plie, push and point, plie. Good. You're really focusing on pointing your feet off the floor or off your beam. And in the air, your heel, just like you are in relative, is gonna be touching the top of your back foot for a split second. Let's try that three times. Ready? Plie. Push and point. Plie. Good. Two more. Last one. Very good. All right, let's try that on the other side. Start in your plie. Buns are under, back is flat. Stretch jump, push and point. Plie. Now we're going to practice the arms. So as you jump and leave the balance beam, your arms are going to go up the front to crown. So at the top of your jump, your arms are in crown. And then they're going to melt down the side and finish here. So let's try the arm pathway without the jump. So start in a plie with your arms here by your side. Go up onto releve. As you go up onto releve, arms are going to go up through the front, hold, down the side. Good, again. Up through the front, hold. Down the side. Good, last one. Up to crown. Birdie down. Good. Other side. Plie. Up the front to crown. Melt down the side. Good, again. Up the front to crown. Down the side. Last one. Up the front to crown. Very good. Now let's add the stretch jump. So it's going to happen a little bit faster. So up the front to crown, birdie down. Here we go. Plie, arms are by your side, back is flat, buns are under. Up the front to crown, birdie down. Good. Two more. All the way up and down. Last one. All the way up and down. If someone were to take a picture of you in the air, you would want to see feet tight and pointed, arms in crown, and a nice straight line from the back of your head all the way down. Let's try the other side. Plie. Up the front to crown. Birdie down. Good. Be sure you're pushing and pointing through those feet. Two more. We're going to transition into some leg kicks before we practice a split jump. When we do leg kicks, I want you to focus on your base leg, so that's your bottom leg, staying nice and straight. So I really don't care how high your front leg goes, so long as you keep this leg straight. What I see a lot of times in class are students trying to lift that front leg up as high as they can, which is awesome, but then their bottom leg, their base leg, does this dipping action. And we don't really want to see that. Instead, I'd like to see a small lift and a straight bottom leg. All right. Arms are going to be out to the side, parallel to the floor. Front foot in tendu, so you're pointing your toe and touching it to the beam. Arms out to the side. Amazing posture. So tall and tight through your belly button, all the way through the top of your head. We're going to simply lift and lower 10 times. Here we go. One, two, both legs are straight. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Let's hold this one for 10. Nine, eight, seven, point that front foot. Six, five, two, one, close to beam feet. Good, now your back foot points to the back. Be sure you're squeezing your quad muscles as tight as they go so that your leg is really straight. And then using your hamstrings and your bottom, you're gonna lift your back leg up and lower down. Be sure that you're not dipping forward with your chest. Everything stays upright in alignment. All right, here we go. Arabesque lifts. One, two, three, four, five, six. Back leg is as straight as it goes. Seven, eight, nine, and hold for 10. Nine, eight, seven, six, five. Point that back foot. Four, three, two, one, and close to beam feet. Melt down. Very good. All right. Let's try that same sequence on the other side. So your other leg is in front. Arms are out to the side. Focus on your posture first. So abs are tight. Shoulders are pressed back, long neck. Both legs are going to stay nice and straight. Ready? Lift. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold this last one for 10. Point that front foot. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Close to beam feet. Back foot point. Leg is so straight. So squeeze your quads, those muscles in the front of your leg, and then using your hamstring and your bottom, you're gonna lift your back leg up and down while keeping your chest up. So it should be a pretty small lift. It's not gonna be huge. Keep it kind of small so that you can maintain a straight leg. All right, arabesque kicks. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold for 10, nine, eight. Point that foot. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Close to your feet. Melt the arms down. Awesome. All right, we're ready to try some split jumps. When we do split jumps, I really don't care how big your split goes. Instead, I care about your posture, so keeping your chest upright as opposed to hinging forward or arching back. And then I also care about how straight your legs are. So I'd rather you do a really small split with amazing posture and super straight legs as opposed to a big sloppy split. So, let's practice the arm pathway first, and then we'll add the legs. Your arms are gonna start down by your side, just like they did in our stretch jump. But instead of going up the front and down the side, the arms are a little bit more simple. You're simply gonna go out to the side and back down. So it's like this, up, down, very simple. We wanna try to avoid bringing our shoulders up. Maintain that long neck. All right. Let's try just going to releve. So plie, releve, plie. Good, it's a little faster. So up, down, good, two more. Up, down, good. Now let's try adding the split jump. Keep it really small so that you can work on your posture and your straight legs. Ready, plie, split jump. Good, two more, plie. Split jump. Last one. Plie. Split jump. Very good. Opposite side. Remember, we're going to do everything on our left and right. Let's practice our arms, our arm pathway to start. So plie. Go up onto releve. Arms go to the side. Hold. Plie. Get a little faster. Up. Down. Again. Up. Down. Last one. Good, now we're gonna add that really small split jump. Maintain your posture, your straight line, and nice tight leg. Three of these mini split jumps, ready? One. Ooh, this side's a little bit harder for me. Two. Last one, three. Good. That's great, you're doing awesome. Okay, if you're ready for a bigger split jump, you can go ahead and try that now. Be sure though, you maintain your amazing posture, you're keeping your chest up, and that your legs are straight. If you notice that you're leaning forward, flying backwards, or that your legs are bending, or your feet aren't pointed, do a smaller split to work on your form. And then eventually, you'll have a nice big split jump. So you'll plie, big split jump, back to plie. Good. Let's try one more. Plie, chest is up, you're in alignment, split jump, back to plie. Great work. All right, we're gonna finish this video with a few leaping drills that you can practice at home. So, we're gonna start in tendu like we did for our kicks. And I know I said keep your base leg straight. We're doing kicks, that's really important. But when we're leaping, we actually want a slight bend in our base leg. So we're gonna start here and lift up that front leg. So this leg is straight, this leg is bent. Good, and then all we're gonna do is hop forward. Oh, let's try that again. You're gonna hop forward and absorb into your base leg. So, front leg up, small bend through your base leg, hop forward, and then you're gonna switch. This leg will bend, this leg will straighten. Good, and then you're gonna hold, bent, straighten. Good. Let's try a few more. Bend. There we go, that was better. Takes a little bit of practice. Let's try two more on this side, and then we'll switch legs. Lift the front leg up, small bend through your base leg this time, and then you're going to pull. Good, last one. Now the goal here is to push through your base leg, go up, and then absorb by bending the front leg and all of your weight's going into your foot. Leg goes up, bend the base leg, look forward, leap, hold. Big back leg is straight. All right, other side. Arms out to the side, lift that leg, base leg bends. Absorb. This leg's harder for me. Try again. Leap. Absorb, that was better. Nice job, you guys. Let's try three more. Lift that front leg up. Bend your base leg. Leap. Absorb. Back leg is as tight as it goes. Leg up. Base leg bends. Very good, last one. Try to go a little higher this time. Up and hold. All right, great job, you guys. You did awesome. Keep working on those stretch jumps, split jumps, and leaps. Remember, posture is really important. Straight legs are really important. And then height. So you want to really push through your strong legs and your strong feet to get up off the balance beam or up off of your floor line. I hope you guys had a good time. See you next time.